Earlier today, I was reading an article on Forbes, and in this article, they said 82% of hiring managers consider culture and value alignment to play an important role when it comes to hiring and building their teams. 82% is clearly significant. So while it pays to be a good fit from a background and experience and qualification standpoint, it obviously pays dividends to come across as a good values and culture fit as well. But how do you do that? When you're sitting there in an interview and they're asking you questions, how do you make it clear that you fit their values? It's actually not that hard. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to do just that. Let's go. I'm Ben White with Ben Talks Talent. I've got 11 years experience in talent acquisition, recruiting, team building, hiring, and I am passionate about using my experience to help you become the best candidate possible. If you came to this channel because you were interested in being a better interviewer so you can land your next job, well, good news, you came to the right place. If you haven't yet, do me a favor, take 3 seconds, subscribe to the channel and hit that notification bell. And if you are not new and you are returning, well, hey, welcome back. Today, I want to talk about something that's really important, and that's coming across as a value fit when you're interviewing for a company. More than ever, companies are looking for people who fit their values. They are looking for people who are going to fit into their culture and be good teammates and meet whatever the cultural values they have assigned and defined and put on their website. They're looking for people who fit that. So it's no longer good enough to be qualified for a job. It's no longer good enough to be able to do the job. You want to also show them that in addition to that, you are going to fit in well. And it matters. And I'm going to show you how to do just that today. So the first step, the first thing we're going to talk about is going and doing the research. So what you want to do is go to a company website, right? So let's just say you're interested in interviewing for Facebook and you want to go there and you want to find out, okay, what makes me a good fit? So you can do a few things. You can go to facebook.com, go to their careers page or their about us page. And you can look at them, and what you want to do is you want to take their values, you want to write them down. They have definitions too. So they have 5 core values and they have definitions behind them. Get that, copy it, paste it into a Word document. There you have it. Those are their values. The other option is you can actually Google Facebook values. And that's what I did, and it brought them up. I confirmed with their website. Those are their values. So those are them. So first things first, you need to identify what are the values, what makes up the culture of the organization. Ideally, in a perfect world, they have 4 or 5 cultural values. And that can start to inform your process of how you're going to incorporate that into your interviewing strategy. So let's talk about Facebook's values. So they have 5. They have be bold, focus on impact, move fast, be open, and build social value. Now, those are just kind of the phrases and keywords here. Now, behind each one of those values, they have a definition, and it pays for you to read those definitions. But just to put this into practice and to talk through how you're going to weaponize these values to become a more effective interviewer, those are the 5. That kind of suffices. So that's first step. Do research, identify them, copy them, familiarize yourself with their values. Let's go on to the next step. Now, the key here is once you've identified what the values are, is figuring how you're going to weave that into your interviewing strategy. The key here is to find out what the 5 values are and find a way to incorporate those values into the questions they ask you. Now, I'm going to break this into 2 categories. There are the no-brainer examples. So these are the questions that they're going to ask you that it's clear, it's easy. You go, okay, here's the question. It's easy for me to weave in the values. So we're gonna talk about those a little bit. And then when we're done with that, we're gonna talk about some more challenging questions and questions where maybe it's not obvious that you could talk about their core values, but you actually can. So do me a favor, stick around to the second half of this video, because those are really interesting ways to use the values, to position yourself as a great candidate. So let's start with the no-brainer questions. These are the questions that when they ask you, it's, oh yeah, I can obviously talk about values here. So the first one, why are you interested in leaving your current job? It's kind of a sneaky one, but it's really good for this. So what you want to do is set the stage and develop leverage. You know, I'm actually not looking to leave my job per se. I'm pretty happy where I'm at. However, I have always been interested in Facebook. Facebook really resonates with me. Some of your core values, especially move fast, focus on impact, that hits home with me because that's what motivates me to get up and do my job on a day-to-day basis. So while I'm not looking for a new job necessarily, I've always been interested in Facebook, and when I saw this job description pop up, I found it on LinkedIn. I felt like it made sense to explore it. When I read the job description, I felt incredibly interested and motivated to apply, so that's kind of why I'm looking. Now, you see what I did there? I first established leverage by saying, I'm not really looking. Second, I doubled down on their values. I talked about how their values drew me into the organization. You know, when you talk about be bold, focus on impact, those are things that resonate with me. That is a good way to weave that in. Now, the other easier question you might get is, why are you interested in Facebook? That's an easy one. Be like, you know, when I was growing up, I have used your platform and I've always thought it was a great way to stay in touch with people. But more importantly than that, besides it being a great product, I also really find your values aligned with my values. I'm really big on being open to experience. I'm really big on focusing on impact. So the fact that those are your company values and they hit home with me made me even more compelled to interview for this role. Something along those lines, but basically what you're doing is you're telling them that their core values are your core values. The things that motivate them motivate you. That is basically telling them, guess what? I am a culture fit. The reality is, a lot of people, a lot of recruiters, a lot of hiring managers, a lot of HR people will probably be impressed that you're even able to say these are your values. Just knowing them shows that you did research, shows that you care, shows that you prepared. Those are all things that most people value. The next thing I want to talk about is behavioral interview questions, because behavioral interview questions are actually fertile ground for incorporating their values into your answer. So behavioral interview question is basically any interview question that starts with, tell me about a time when. What it is forcing you to do is recall an example of something you've done in your past and then talk them through your thought process and the outcome of it. Now remember, anytime you hear the beginning of that and you identify it as, that's a behavioral interview question, you want to incorporate the STAR method for answering the interview question. So what is the STAR method? That's situation, task, action, result. So when they ask you a question, like for example, one of the ones we have here is, give me an example of a time you had to handle competing deadlines. You want to think about, okay, what was the situation I was in? What was a task I had to complete? And then the new one, because it's competing deadlines, what was the action I took and what was the result? So you want to think about that, right? So that's how you answer this question. If you get that interview question, this is a great time to incorporate one of their values, specifically move fast. You go, you know, I had a situation where I was involved in a project. You know, we were making good progress. I was communicating with a client and then my boss said, hey, Ben, I've got this new project. It takes priority. We need you to move on to that. So while I was deep into this project, what I was able to do was I was able to talk to one of my coworkers who was able to take that from me. So we did a quick handoff in which I communicated the information. And then I quickly moved on to the next project. Knowing my boss, he is not someone who does that very frequently. So the fact that he did that, I knew it was a priority. So I knew I had to move quickly to execute on that next role, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. It is a way for you to weave in a cultural value into your answer. Let's do another one. So let's say they ask you a question. Tell me about a time when you made a mistake that caused you to have to redo some important work in a time-sensitive situation. That is a pretty classic behavioral interview question, but it is also an opportunity for you to incorporate one of Facebook's core values. So one of their values is be open. So you wanna look at this and be like, you know, there was a time when I had a situation and I had a really regimented way of handling a process. But when I got into it, I realized that I missed something. Luckily for me, I was able to connect with a coworker and I said, hey, this didn't turn out the way I wanted it to. Can you give me your perspective? I think it's really important to be open to learning from people and gathering the information from other people and gathering different perspectives. So what I did was I talked with my coworker, they gave me their process for executing on the, you know, whatever the thing was. And because of that, I was able to learn, move forward and execute it more successfully in the future. What you did there is you took one of their core values, be open, and you wove it into your story. You talked about how it's important to you to be open to learning from other people. And you brought that into the story. So these are just two examples, but I want you to think about that. You can't do any of this unless you familiarize yourself with a company's core values. So quick recap, when you're interviewing for a company, look for their company core values. Typically they'll have, you know, anywhere between 3 to 8 core values. Typically on the website they'll have definitions. So familiarize yourself with what be open means to them. And then I want you to use it when you're answering their questions. The easy ones, why are you interested in Facebook? Why are you interested in leaving your current role? Those are easy. But when you get behavioral interview questions, I want you to practice a few common behavioral interview questions and how you can weave their values into your answers. It's going to make you appear to be an extremely compelling candidate. You know, in a perfect world, your core value match. And they know your core value match. But the reality is, unless you show them that, they're probably not gonna see it. But if you take the time, do the research, and incorporate it into your answers, you're going to show them clearly that you're a great value match. So that's it, that is everything, that is a video. I hope you found value here. If you did, do me a favor, hit that like button. It is a good way for you to tell YouTube that I don't suck. Thank you for taking the time to watch this video. Have a great rest of the day. Good luck in your next interview. You've got this.